Hello everyone and welcome to Brandy's Cards. I hope that you guys can see me. I'm just refreshing my screen here to make sure that we have a good connection. I hope everybody's doing good. I'm so excited to be here. Here I am. So let me just refresh one more time so that I can see comments and see who is all here with me today. I have been so excited to share today's project with you. I've worked really hard on these and I can't hardly wait to show you how good they look with the blending brushes. So much fun. So I'm going to use the Seascapes Stamp Set. So when I was trying to figure out what I wanted to share with you guys today, I have to tell you that Doug and I had earned the incentive trip to Maui with the other wonderful Stampin' Up! Demonstrators and family. And unfortunately, we weren't able to go. The boys had finals this week and next week. And we just, you know, being the first time in high school as a freshman, and then also Dylan being a seventh grader, we just felt like we couldn't go this time. So today we are going to celebrate all of my friends and Stampin' Up! Family over there in Hawaii with some beautiful seahorses and some fish. So I'm really excited about that. All right, I'm going to look down and see who's in here with me today. So hi Barb, I see you're in here. And hi Joe Smith, hello. Terry's in here. And Ann and Mary Lou, hi Kathy. Oh my gosh, it's so good to see you all. Hi Raquel. Hello Miss Roxy, I had so much fun talking to you the other day. You're such a gem. And you have a package that's gonna show up tomorrow, so I hope you're looking for that. Oh, and by the way, Miss Roxy there, Raquel, she sent some pictures. I'm super excited. I'm going to brag on you for a moment. You know, when we talk about making cards, we always talk about sometimes ministries and how we like to send our cards. Well, Miss Raquel, she is making graduation cards. She is a manager, a trainer at McDonald's, and she has been for 30 some years. Amazing. And she has been training some of the young kids and students that come to work at the McDonald's. And so she just, with COVID and stuff, she wanted to make sure that their graduation was super special. So she was so excited. She made a bunch of graduation cards and she made them specific for each student with the colors of their school and what they like. So thank you for doing that and for sharing your love of crafting and your talent with so many others. They're gonna remember you, absolutely. So thank you for doing that. It was just a really neat story. So I just wanted to share that with you since we are upon graduation. It's crazy. My boys are gonna be out of school next week. So we're gonna have to put Dylan to work filming some videos. That's right. All right, hi Miss Cheryl. And Angela's in here. Hi Julie. And Marilyn and Carrie Bristol. Hello Carrie. We haven't talked in a while. Hi Felicia. All right, so also in here is Priscilla and Amanda. And as you guys know, they work for Brandy's Cards. They're also a good friend of mine. Super excited that they're here. So thank you ladies for helping. And Doug and Miss Peyton. Yes, they're like, we want a shout out. No doubt. They are definitely driving this train, right? I do the talking and the creating and the fun stuff. And they're behind the scenes. And so super excited. We have a new member of the Brandy's Cards family, Peyton. And Peyton is from Ohio. She goes to Ohio University. And she's majoring in film and social marketing type stuff. And so we're just so excited. I snatched her up. Her dad built my craft table. And I was like, would Peyton want to come to help and work? And so he was like, I think she would. So it's really, really cool. So Peyton is learning how to be a part of it and to film and that sort of thing. So very excited about that. All right. So I see Mike Hines, but I know Mike Hines is Missy. Hi, Missy. Welcome. I'm so glad you were able to make it. Hope you're enjoying your vacation with your family. I also want to give a shout out to Vicky. I saw you in here earlier, Vicky. I've been praying for you and I saw your surgery was Monday. So I hope that you're doing well. And the fact that you're in here with us tonight, I hope that's a good sign that you're starting to feel better and you're on the mend. So hi, Miss Patty and Judith and Betty. All right, I'm just so excited. Thank y'all for joining me tonight. I'm so glad to have you here. So I'm just gonna kind of go over a little bit of housekeeping as far as some of the things that are going on and for May. Now, y'all should have your annual catalogs, right? If you don't have your catalog, well, let me know. You should have it, especially if you've made a purchase with me in the last 12 months. And so you would absolutely get a complimentary catalog. Now, sometimes they get lost in the mail. Things get wonky, can't explain it, and sometimes I don't even try. So just let me know. And of course, if you don't have a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator and you're interested in purchasing some product, please reach out to me at BrandysCards. I'd love the opportunity to help you and earn your business and send you one of these treasures. These books are fantastic. All right, so that is the annual catalog. Of course, our spring catalog is still going. I call it the spring catalog. Its new name is January through June 2021. But, you know, I go with spring catalog, but you can call it whatever you would like. So this catalog is good through June. And so, you know, everybody should have one of those too. So if you have any questions about that, please let me know. Couple of really cool promotions going on right now. Stampin' Up! Has the Connect, Craft, and Collect. And so that is basically their extra host rewards. So if you place an order that qualifies for extra host rewards, well, you get an extra $25. So it's a really good deal, and it's really, you know, quite nice to have that extra, you know, bits to purchase more free stuff. We all like more stuff, right? So that's awesome. So that's what that is. It is also on Brandy's Cards, and you can email me if you have any questions. And then, of course, we have the new team member, the new team joining to become a new team member. So I see there's lots of my team members in here right now. Kathy's in here, Kathy Berard. Thank you for being in here. I so appreciate you supporting me tonight and being here to craft with us. So I love my team. I'm so grateful for all of them. We have a lot of fun. We were doing craft and shares now, and we've got a B&B, Blooms and Butterflies is our team. And we have a B&B team day coming up on June 12th, which I'm over the moon excited. I have like a really fun day planned out. And Miss Priscilla is gonna be doing a presentation in there as well. I hope it wasn't a surprise, Priscilla, because I just totally told everybody. But it's gonna be really fun, and we're super excited about that. Of course, our team has the opportunity to earn the Creativate Retreat for free as well. So that's pretty cool. So if you're interested in joining, let me know. Of course, you know, the only requirement if you decide to join is that you make your quarter. So just reach out to me and we can talk about that. I'd love the opportunity to share with you. And of course, I think you would love being a part of the Stampin' Up! Family and of course our team, my team. So very excited about being here tonight and sharing all of that with you. Now, we do have a winner from last week, but I'm not gonna tell you yet. No, I'm gonna make y'all wait. You guys are like, oh, I'm gonna choke her. No, really. I'm gonna share with you guys in a little bit, but first, I am super excited to kind of get ready and dive in today's projects. They're really a lot of fun. You're gonna need the blending brushes. Let me show you these. So these are our new blending brushes. They are amazing. I offered them as a host code gift, I don't know, a couple months ago, and they were fantastic. So really, really awesome. I think they're on page 129 of your annual catalog up in the top right-hand corner. They're fabulous and you will love them. And so I have a whole line of them here today. So I'm excited to show you kind of how I blended some of those colors together. All right, so I see Amanda and Cindy, and Arlene is in here too. Hi, Arlene, and Karen Shin, and Miss Shirley, welcome. Thank you for being here, ladies. I'm so grateful. All right, so I'm gonna move my computer over a little bit, and I am going to show you the fun stamp set that we are gonna work with today. So this is the stamp set. It's called Seascapes, and the dyes that go with it are Sea Life dyes. And oh, these dyes are amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing for so many reasons. But I'm excited to show you how you can make such a beautiful die cut image out of these, okay? But of course, the first thing we always have to do is we have to open up our Stampin' Up! Catalog, right? We can't just, you know, sometimes we just don't have the mojo going and we just are like, okay, yes, it's super cool, but what in the world do I do with it? And so what I recommend always is go to your Stampin' Up! Catalog and open that up and you can look at the different samples and think, okay, well, gosh, I could put this here and maybe the fish. And so use your catalog as your idea book. Okay, so I say this over and over because that is exactly how I get my inspiration, and that's where I start always, is with my catalog, because I feel like if I recreate something out of the catalog, maybe I don't love it, but it always gets me kind of in the groove and in the mood. So here we go. This is what I'm looking for. And so this one is your Seascapes stamp set. And I didn't bring out my diorama dies this time, but I think what I'm gonna do is a follow-up video with this because it is absolutely phenomenal. But anyway, we're not gonna do that today. We're gonna focus on this beautiful seahorse and the goldfish. But down here, you can see the dies, right? And so Stampin Up has die cut those out to kind of make them dark there for you to see. Absolutely beautiful. And many of you probably know this, but I'm gonna go ahead and show you anyway. There is samples here, right, of these two images. But here in the back, we have more samples. And this shows you where our bundles are. And down here, it's gonna show you more samples. And these samples are gonna be different than the samples that you're gonna find on the other page. So here's another seahorse. As you can see here, I loved kind of how the background was stamped, and I thought that the seahorse was so beautiful. So I took this idea and I took some of these others and I thought, okay, here we go. We're gonna dive in and see what we can do. All right, so first card that we have today, of course I'm not gonna show it to you yet, but let me just bring this over. Okay, so I have all of my parts and pieces. It just makes it so much easier for me. So what I'm gonna do is I have a piece of Whisper White, of course, but we're gonna bring in our cabana. Now, one thing if you notice, if you have your annual catalog, I'm just gonna show you one more time. And next time I'm gonna just leave this catalog open to that page because I do like to refer to it quite frequently. So here I could show you that you see like the seaweed and how it's kind of stamped kind of going up. Well, I thought that was super cool and I wanted to play off of that. I also am gonna play off of the seahorse and, you know, the coral. So I'm gonna grab myself my, I've got a space to stamp on here, my grid paper, and I have some Coastal Cabana. And so I'm gonna take my Coastal Cabana and I have some little bubbles. And so mine, instead of the seaweed, since you've already seen the seaweed in the catalog, I'm going with bubbles. That's right. Cause you know, I like to switch things up a little bit. So we're gonna do some bubbles and you know, even pool party works well with this. But today I am using Coastal Cabana. Now you can turn it so the bubbles don't all look totally uniform, right? We don't want them to be all exactly the same. But you know, I don't think anybody would notice if they were, right? So there we go. Oh, those are some super cool bubbles right there. Those are some bubbles. And so now I have my Whisper White cardstock, or basic white, and I am going to use some liquid adhesive and I'm gonna add that to the front of my card. Super easy so far. Oh, look at that. Can you see my cardstock? I was playing with this idea earlier too. So it's so fun. And you know, that's the beauty of having two sides to every piece of cardstock is that, you know, nothing goes to waste. So I love that. Love it, love it, love it. Hi, hi there, Joan and Sharon. So good to see everybody in here. Thank you for being here tonight. Okay, so I'm gonna put this away and try to keep my space somewhat neat for you. I have soft suede. So here is soft suede, and I have the little speckles in the stamp set. They kind of look like sand, don't they? This is crumb cake cardstock, and I have my speckles. And so if you're looking at your Stampin' Up! Catalog, I'm totally starting to play off the idea that's already in the catalog. And so I'm just gonna add a little bit of speckles, kind of create myself some sand. As you can see, I've stamped off, I've stamped straight on with a soft suede, I've stamped off a couple different times, and that gives me a little bit of more depth. And so, you know, always remember that you can, you know, you can achieve more colors just by stamping off. It's quite fantastic. Okay, so hi Yolanda, thanks for joining us today. All right, so here we go. I am gonna take, I love to tear paper, and I am, and that is a true story. You can ask any one of my team members, and they will tell you that Brandy has this thing with tearing paper. Love it. I don't know why that is so much, but I think I just think it just adds a little something that's so cool. I love that. Okay, so I'm gonna add that right along the bottom. Now again, if you open up your Stampin' Up! Catalog, you're gonna see a goldfish in there, and that goldfish has some sand along the bottom. I thought that was super cool, and I decided I wanted to kind of play off of that. And so that is why I decided to add that there today. Now we have another piece of cardstock, but then I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna show you the seahorse. So let me grab the Big Shot or the cut and emboss machine, and I'm gonna pull this up here, and I need a piece of Whisper white paper here. Let me see, I might have to cut a piece of cardstock. So here, I'll just use this piece right here, and let me make sure that you can see me okay. I have the dies, and let me grab the seahorse. So the really cool thing about this die is that you can put it in the middle of your cardstock, just like this. And when you run it through, it does not actually pop all the way out. So it's really cool. It gives you some different ways that you can use this die, which I think is super cool. All right. So let me take my cut and emboss away here. And I'm gonna set that aside. And so I'm gonna bring that back. And I also have my handy take your pick tool and the die brush. This thing is fantastic. Absolutely love it. But when you're doing this guy, you're gonna want your trash close by because he definitely has lots of little pieces. And so I'm just kind of poking some of these outer, these little holes that helps you kind of release, you know, the image or the, you know, the part of it that's die cut that's kind of stuck in there. But look at that, that's cool. Look how amazing he is. Absolutely fantastic. And so let me show you. This is not what we're gonna do with him quite yet. But look at that. So you can put him on top of another piece of cardstock and he shows right through. So absolutely amazing. And so of course, you know, you can fancy him up just on here. So really, really cool. All right, so let me go ahead and show you. I'm gonna put this die away and clean up here. So I'm gonna bring my scrap paper back in and I have this one that's been already cut. Now what you're gonna do is what I have found is, let's say you want him free, right? You don't want him stuck in there. So look at this, he's only connected by 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces. So watch this, I am gonna go in here and snip, that's one. And there's another little snip, snip, there's two. And then I found the easiest thing to do is kind of push up this fin, and there's one that's a straight line there. And then there is a line that goes right there. See that? And so now he's cut out. Oh, how cool is that? So now he's free. And now we can make him look beautiful. He's free. They're laughing at me, but that's okay. I can handle it. I can, right? Okay, so here we go. So this was how, this. I had so much fun doing this. I have got to tell you, I had a big time. Like, so much fun. And I'm gonna put all of these out here, and I might just move my camera up just a little bit so that I can, so I've got room. So this is Rich Razzleberry, and this one is Polished Pink, and this one is Bumblebee. Polished Pink and Bumblebee, okay. So what we're gonna do is I have my dye brushes here, and I love these dye brushes, they're pretty fantastic. And so I have a Razzleberry, I have my pink, and then I also have the yellow one. So I use this one for my pink, Razzleberry, kind of the dark purples, and that one's gonna be for my bumblebee. So here, this is what I started with. I took this one, this is Razzleberry, and kind of dabbed it on there. And you have your seahorse, and I am gonna start off, and I'm gonna start working my way onto my seahorse. And you'll start to see kind of him take shape and some color. Now the idea here is I just, it's a dark color, so I wanna focus my attention for the most part here kind of on, you know, kind of on his little spiny area, the back of him. And it's just so much fun. These blending brushes blend so beautifully. Oh my gosh, so pretty. Okay, so the cool thing is you can always make him darker. So, you know, don't fret, you know, if you, let's just say, you know, you can't really take the ink off, right? So just start light, and then you can make him darker as you go. So I'm gonna set that aside, that's Razzleberry. Now I have some polished pink. I'm gonna take my polished pink, start off, and this is what I did, is I took the polished pink, and lightly I came back in, starting off my paper, and I'm gonna add some pink, and I'm kind of focused on this second layer. That's kind of what my focus is trying to kind of play off of that beautiful Razzleberry color and kind of bringing it in a little bit deeper. And again, I can always go back, but I can't take it off. So that's why I'm kind of being a little cautious as I go down my seahorse. So I can already see that, oh, I want him darker on the edges. So we can take our Razzleberry and kind of come back over his little spiny, little like just like that, and kind of make that a little bit darker. Oh yeah. Do you see how that's getting darker and how beautiful that is? It's probably a little hard to see until I pull him away, but holy wow, it's really cool. Super cool. All right, so can you see he's starting, oh, that's so pretty. Oh my gosh. Oh, it makes me excited. Okay, so here is the next one. This one is Bumblebee. And so I don't really want him entirely colored. I do want a little bit of white, so I am gonna start on this other side. And I'm gonna kinda just come in with some yellow. Now you could, if you didn't wanna do yellow, you could do pale peach, I'm sorry, pale papaya is the color, so you could do that one. But I am gonna add just a little bit, I'm just gonna bring it in a little bit darker here towards his belly, just like that. All right, so I think he's good. He is absolutely beautiful. Oh my gosh. Okay, so the next thing that we have here is we have some coral. So when you run this dye through to get your coral, here's what you get. And so it's fun, you know, these little pieces actually kind of pop up if you want them to. I didn't really have time to go through and pop them up, so I wasn't too terribly worried about that. But what I did do is I took my bumblebee and I have my dye brush and I started from the bottom. Now again, if you look at the Stampin' Up! Catalog, I basically sort of followed their idea. I just kind of merged a few things together is what I ended up doing and kind of taking my own spin on things. And so that is the beauty of our crafting. Now, one thing I want to point out, when I had this dye up here and I was sponging, I was actually sort of picking up some of this purple and it kind of gets a little muddy. And I learned that earlier today that, you know, these brushes are supposed to blend the color. So if you're blending over the same color in a different color, well, you're kind of picking up that color. So you kind of have to move it just so that you can control and get the color that you're looking for. So I am just kind of going up here. I don't mind the basic white up here, but I just want it just a little bit darker, maybe. Maybe a little bit darker on the tips over here. And maybe up here a little bit. Cool, okay. I think this looks great. All right, so let's go ahead and I'm gonna show you how I put this beautiful piece together. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put these away because I do not want to have any accidents. So I'm gonna just kinda put that away and I will then be able to show you. Okay, So here it is. So let's see. So I have a piece of my basic white. I took a little, just a little scrap, and I stamped my thank you sentiment. And I'm going to add a little banner, I think. The little banner is just going to go here. I don't mind cutting my own banner, and I don't mind if they're not even. But if you do, a lot of times our punches also work and help with that too. Okay, so I need some Stampin' Dimensionals and potentially some mini glue dots. I'm going to take my Stampin' Dimensional and I'm going to put it right here. It does fit quite nicely right there behind there, the bottom base of the coral. And then what I'm going to do is I didn't have any mini dimensionals because I actually sent them to my team members for their birthday gifts in their birthday cards. So I'm gonna just kind of make do. And what I did is I cut a normal size dimensional in half. And so that way I had some room. Yeah. Then look at this. This is so cool. And then you can take and you can wrap his little tail around your coral. And so I'm gonna kind of, takes me a second to kind of get him in there. But once you get him in there, it's super cool. And so I think I'm gonna set him right about here. And you've got your coral, just like that. And I think that I want this piece in front. Let's see, do I want it in front? Oh yeah, that's so fun. Oh my gosh, it's so cool. Okay, so you know, the best thing to do would probably be to put your dimensionals on him before you stick him down. And again, if you don't have the small dimensionals, well then just cut yourself a big dimensional and you can just stick one maybe on his belly, maybe on his wing, his fin back here. And we could even put a small one on his face. And so I'm just gonna kind of cut a small one for his face. I'm gonna put it right in here. There's always ways to make do if you, you know, so just, you know, gotta get creative, right? All right, so here we go. I am gonna stick him down right about in here. Oh, so pretty. I hope you guys are liking it so far. Are they loving it? Oh, that makes me so happy. Okay, well, if they're liking it, then I'm gonna keep going. Okay.
Don't be mad at me if I don't like
it. I'm not allowed to stop yet, right? Well, I don't want to stop yet, but okay. So here is my little thank you sentiment, and I am going to take that and kind of, I don't know, stick it in between here somewhere. Maybe right about in there. Can you read it? Yeah. Okay. You sure can. Right there looks pretty good. I love that. Okay. So we're going to flip it over and we're going to add some dimensionals behind our cardstock here. And then, oh my gosh, and then I can't wait to show you the next step. It's pretty simple, but boy, oh boy, does it just make him pop like a crazy man. It's really cool. So here we go. So check that out. Oh yeah. Oh my goodness, that sounded like Mario Bros. Oh yeah. I like to play Mario Bros. With Dylan. It's a lot of fun. Okay, so here we go. The In Color Jewels 2021 through 23. These are one of my host code gifts this month. I absolutely love these gems. I've shown them to you before, and I feel fairly confident that other demonstrators have probably showed them as well. They are absolutely stunning. Stunning, stunning, stunning. They just have this just wonderful, I don't even know, just really fun look to them. And so what I'm gonna do, this is a polished pink, and this is your pale papaya. This one is evening evergreen. But I was looking at the eye and I thought, gosh, you know, we could put a few little gems around. And a lot of times, because I don't want to ruin my gems, and I'm sure some of you could relate to me, right? You're like, oh, I don't want to mess up my gems. So sometimes what I do is I take a little package, you know, like a little, you know, envelope or something, and I will cut my gems on the plastic. And I do that for a reason, because if I do that, well, then I can put them on my card and I can just move them around and I can say, okay, yes, I like that. No, I don't like that. But the good thing is I haven't ruined my little gem. He's still good and I can still use it and I can still put it somewhere, right? So that looks pretty cool just like that, I think, doesn't it? Having some gems kind of around him. So I think that's really cool. But I have to tell you that my most favorite thing was this evening evergreen gem. Absolutely phenomenal. So watch this. I'm gonna go ahead and put it right here in his eye. And you know what? His head is probably, I might need to put a little mini glue dot underneath there so that you can see that gem better. Or actually instead of that, because I popped up his head and there's a hole there. So he's kind of in there. So why don't we grab the big one? Let's do a big evening evergreen. And now we are doing good. So we're gonna stick that right in there. Oh my goodness, is that not just beautiful with his eye being evening evergreen? Oh, so beautiful. Absolutely stunning, stunning. And you know, if you like the other little gems, well gosh, you can add them on there. I just felt like, you know, with his eye being evening evergreen, I just loved how that popped him, that I didn't feel like I needed some of these other colors on here, but you certainly can for sure. Yeah, you guys, Denise. Hi, Miss Denise. I love you and I love your emails. You are the sweetest. So thank you for being in here with me tonight. I just adore you. Okay, so here we go. So that one is the first one of tonight's fun cards. And so before I move on though, I want to show you, just to kind of show you that. So this one has the, this one has the seaweed that goes up. This one has the bubbles. This one has the sand. I put it over here and I kind of played off of their idea and I added color to my coral. So super fun and just really easy. Now, let me show you another card. This was where I started actually. I went ahead and designed my fish along the same lines as Stampin' Up! Did in the catalog. I added a few of the soft succulent gems to my little bubbles. So that was super fun, you know, just to kind of get my mojo going and kind of get things flowing. But then from there, I decided, well, what if I start playing a little bit with the color of my, seahorse, right? Because they can just, you know, seahorses can be all kinds of different colors, can't they? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use Pool Party, I'm gonna use Coastal Cabana, and of course I'm gonna add Bermuda Bay. I mean, it wouldn't be like me if I didn't add any Bermuda Bay, right? So what you've got in front of you here is, this is our Seashells 3D embossing folder. Absolutely gorgeous, not new. You guys have seen this before. I love it, and so I've already ran it through my cut and emboss machine. And I've got my basic white, and I'm just gonna go ahead and add that to the top of my card, okay? And I am today not gonna do anything with this seashell embossing folder. There are a million fabulous, fabulous, gorgeous ideas out there. You can do shimmer paint on this guy. You can do all kinds of fantastic techniques. But today I am focused on my seahorse and on this beautiful stamp set. So basically this is just another basic white. And then I have another seahorse. And this seahorse, I've actually, you know, this is just a rectangle, and he is not cut out. He's actually still in there. So I have not snipped him out, okay? But I have another one here that I am gonna snip out because I wanna show you the colors really quick here. So I'm gonna snip him out and just show you how easy it is. And so I hope, actually I found it easier to go that direction. Every time I've done it, it's like, oh yeah, that's the direction. And so you can see this is the one I wanted to cut. All right, so here he is. And I'm gonna throw that in the trash. I'm gonna grab my scrap paper again. And I have my seahorse here. And so now what we're gonna do is we are going to play with some other colors. And so you can do a couple of different things. I have Coastal Cabana, Pool Party, and let's see, what else do I have? I have Bermuda Bay, and I have Shaded Spruce. Those are the colors that I have now. And so let's just go ahead and open these all up. and I generally put all my little stickers in there so I can see what the colors are, but clearly today I have not done that. So we'll just have to be careful. All right, so check this out. I have, this is gonna be shaded spruce. So I'm gonna start here and I'm gonna come in on my shaded spruce and add a bit of that to my seahorse. Again, kind of along the same idea as, as the other one. And this one I did do, you know, I liked the dark kind of around the edge the best, right? But you could always switch it up. You could always come in the other way from his belly. But I am gonna go ahead and grab Granny Apple Green because I think that would really be beautiful. So to kind of clean off the color, I kind of use the same one for blending with the greens. I don't worry too much. As long as you just kind of, you know, go in a circle and clean it off a little bit so you're good to go. So we're gonna get some Granny Apple Green and we're gonna come back in. And oh, look at that, is that not beautiful? Oh my gosh, it's so pretty, so pretty. And so you can kind of see, and you know, the harder you push, the darker it's gonna get and the more you spin on it. So, you know, if you, I didn't say spit on it, I said spin. Yeah, I just want to clarify because it sounded like I said spit on it. That's not good. That is not what I meant. So I am just kind of coming over his face and kind of coming onto his belly a little bit. I do like a little bit of the white space, so I'm not gonna go much more with that. But I am going to get some more shaded spruce and kind of come back in on his belly down here, maybe a little bit on his tail. Okay, so as you can see, he's totally coming together quite beautifully. I feel like his head might need a little bit more. Kind of darken him up a little bit up here at the top. And so then, after we do all of that, and again, if you want more on his spikies, you know, you can kind of just go back and forth. But check how beautiful that is. So, so pretty. So then to take it a step further, what you can do is you can take your blue, you know, blending brush, and I am gonna just go ahead and take some Pool Party, and I'm gonna come in on another piece of my basic white and blend some Pool Party, and then I'm gonna add some Coastal, and the Coastal is gonna start giving me a bit more depth, right? And then I'm probably gonna add my Bermuda Bay because I love Bermuda Bay. You know, the world would not be right if I didn't add that. As Amanda said, did you add Bermuda Bay? Yes, I added Bermuda Bay. Okay, so then I thought, okay, well, if I want it to match, I'm gonna go ahead and take my shaded spruce. And shaded spruce is gonna come along the edges here. And that shaded spruce just adds another, I don't know, it's just beautiful. It adds another depth. And it's kind of, you know, it works really well with these blues. And so I'm just kind of coming in along the side right here. And I see somebody says, oh, Cindy says she loves the blues together. Hi, Debbie. I love the blues and greens too. Just stunning, stunning. Okay. So I do recommend you look at your fingers every now and again. Because when you're blending, I find that, you know, you can get messy. So here, let me go ahead and show you how this puts together. So I have my piece of cardstock for the top. And then, now look at this. You could go this direction and you can see behind your, you know, behind your seahorse, or you can go ahead with some mini glue dots or some liquid adhesive. You can add him right on top. And so now you can just kind of tack him down, maybe in his face, his wing, his belly, and maybe his tail. And now he's on there. And so let me show you the finished card. It's absolutely beautiful. So here it is. This is the finished card. So as I showed you earlier, this is actually stamped in shaded spruce. And this is the background that we just did. I added evening evergreen gems to this to kind of finish it off. Absolutely gorgeous. Those, you know, the greens and the blues just work so well together. Love it, Love it, love it. Now, of course, you could, you know, you could do more with this if you wanted to. I honestly liked the simplicity of it, but you could add shimmer and do all kinds of fun stuff. But I just wanted to show you kind of a place to start and then see what you guys do with it, right? So wowzers, Denise. That's my word. I use that word all the time, wowzers. So here, let me show you this. So here, this
The first two cards were just absolutely fantastic.
Fantastic, I get it. That's awesome.
You know, I love a good pun.
I know. That's awesome. And so as you can see, there are the, you know, those are your Razzleberry and your Polished Pink. And then you have over here, and actually, you know what? This one has the Pale Papaya. This one is Daffodil Delight. So to kind of show you the difference there. In the colors. So yeah, so super fun, super pretty, super easy to do. And so let's move on to our next one. So let me go ahead and kind of move some of these stamp pads really, really quick because I am so afraid that I am going to make a mess. While I'm doing that, I would love to give away the In Bloom bundle. And so I'm gonna go ahead and pull that over. So I have an extra bundle for a lucky winner, and I'm super excited. So the person that was chosen was randomly chosen. The computer just kind of goes through the comments and randomly picks somebody. And this was, you know, we shared some of these cards last week, and I'm just gonna show you. So if you missed the video, you should absolutely go back. This bundle is gorgeous. It really is. And we just made some fun cards with it, right? And so the winner of our In Bloom bundle is Miss Gloria Stocks. Yay! Congratulations, Miss Gloria. I'm super excited. I can't wait to send this to you. I will get that out in the mail to you on Monday. So you can absolutely expect to receive that here really, really soon, okay? All right, yes, Morgan, you could absolutely put Wink of Stella for sure. That is a fabulous idea for sure. Okay, so the next thing I wanted to show you was kind of a spin off of this first card we did. So this first card, do you remember here when we die cut our seahorse here in the center? You guys remember that? So when we did this at the beginning, I thought, well, how cool would it be to die cut that piece kind of where I wanted it on my cardstock? The center is beautiful, but I wanted to have a sentiment, and I'm thinking that I want this to be kind of a more of a note card or something, just a simple card that I can put together quite quickly. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to tear it. Yikes! Yes, I am. I'm gonna tear it. I use my finger to kind of guide. I want these kind of big ruffles, if you will. I feel like it almost looks like waves, sort of. I love that. So cool. But that one's a little, might have to rip him off there. And then I kind of go back and I like to push it and kind of make it all fancy. Now I have another piece here that I just tore off. And this piece is actually gonna go right back on. And this piece is gonna go right under here. Right back on, kind of like that. Okay, and so I'm gonna leave just enough edge so that I can add some actually, this is Coastal Cabana. I was gonna say Calypso Coral. No, this is Coastal Cabana. So check that out. How cool is that? And so I might actually pull this out just a little bit, just like that. And then I'm going to add so that I have a hint of white right there. And so we're just gonna add a bit of liquid adhesive in here. And not a whole lot, just a little wee bit. And I'm just gonna tuck that in there in the crease of my card. We're gonna close it. And now that is nice and taut in there. Perfect. Okay, so then what I thought is, well, why don't, you know, we do the same thing. And I thought that I had cut this guy out, but y'all get to watch me do it again in case you forgot that you can cut him out. You can cut him out. You can see, right? Surely, you guys can tell. You can cut him out. Okay, so here we go. Let's just kind of cut him out of there. And then this little piece down here under his fin. And then you have him there. And so I'm going to go ahead and grab my other scrap paper, if I can find where it went. Okay, there it is. Super. So I have another scrap paper, and on this one, I thought, well, I want him to be, well, they're all quite tropical, really, but I wanted him to be a little bit different, I suppose. So I'm going to start with some polished pink, and I'm going to just start on the edges, and I'm going to kind of add this polished pink right kind of down his spines. And my thought here was that I wanted to maybe incorporate more yellow and oranges, or maybe, you know, some more coral is kind of where I wanted to go with it next. So I have Daffodil Delight, and I have my yellow blending brush. And so I'm gonna kind of come in with that right here at the top, kind of work my way down him. And, you know, again, if you just go light, you can always get darker. Always get darker, but you can't take it away. So you just have to sort of be careful with that because you can't take it away. So just kind of bringing it in, pulling the color in just a bit more, adding a little bit more depth to him. And so as you can see, he's coming along quite nicely. So I've got Bumblebee. What else do I have in here? I have Calypso Coral. Well, you know what? Let's try Calypso Coral. So there is that. Now I think the first one I did, I don't think it was Calypso. I don't know, we'll see. It was either Bumblebee or Calypso, but we're fixing to find out. So here we go. We're gonna come in, and this time I'm coming in from his belly. And you know what? I am thinking I might even just grab my pale papaya instead, because I feel like the pale papaya might just be a little bit lighter. So let's see, do I have my pale papaya out here? Well, it doesn't look like I do. So we'll just start off with Calypso. But I think pale papaya would have been really nice too, because it would have been maybe just a bit lighter. And so I'm just kind of adding that here to his face, just like that, and getting some color in there. And let's see what he looks like. Oh, he's so cute. And so I betcha I could come in with some, to kind of bring this coral to life a little bit more. I betcha I could add some yellow on top of that, some Daffodil Delight. See that? So you have to just play with it. So I recommend, and see how that really kind of makes that a little bit more orangey. So that is perfect. That is exactly what I had hoped for. So you can go back in here and sponge a bit more if you want on his little spines. And just, you know, I could do this all day. It's quite relaxing. These bristles are pretty fantastic. You could almost do your makeup with them. They're that amazingly soft, pretty awesome. Okay, so here, let me show you the finished card. So here's what I thought, is I thought we could take this cool guy right here, and we need Bermuda Bay, and we are going to just stamp a quick sentiment in Bermuda Bay right on top. So here's our thank you. This thank you, you know, I went back and forth with the sentiments in here, and it seems like today, the thank you sentiment won pretty much all day. So, but that's okay. I can always use a thank you note for sure. So there we go, thank you. And I'm gonna ink that up in Bermuda Bay. And I thought, let's just put it right there. Perfect, perfect, perfect. You could even do that in Shaded Spruce if you wanted to. So check this out. Oh, look at that, how beautiful is that? Now what I wanted to show you, and I've already kind of tacked this guy down, but what I wanted to show you was, you know, I saved all of my pieces here because I wanted to show you how cool it is to be able to mount this guy. Let me pull the white in because I think this, actually, you know what? Here we go. Let's pull this piece in. So if you were to put him on top, you could totally play with the colors that you put underneath him. So check that out. Does that not look super cool? Can you see that in the camera? So that is polished pink in the spine of him. This one here is, here's a Calypso coral, so you could put coral in there if you wanted. You could put yellow if you wanted. So there's a cool yellow. What other colors do I have here? I even played with the idea of cutting pieces and kind of making it so that I could have a dual color, that I could have kind of a, you know, a yellow color and another color. So I had all kinds of fun playing with these, and I was just really excited to kind of show you what can be done. So here is my finished card. So this one is gonna layer on top. We're gonna glue this down, and then we're gonna bedazzle that card. That's right, with some really cool in-color gems because they're fabulous. Fabulous, so here is the finished card. And you can see the torn edges that I showed you, and then I added the Costa Cabana behind it. And then you can see I colored my seahorse. So polished pink, and actually I think even, this one could even have some flirty flamingo. I think that one's even flirty flamingo back here. And then you've got your Daffodil Delight and then your coral. So if you pull back in some of these other colors, you can see how creative you can get with this guy. I mean, I've got him here in greens and I have him here in oranges and pinks. And then of course the razzleberry and the purple is just fantastic. So lots of opportunity there for sure. And you know, you can really play with him and just have some fun. So I thought that was super cool and I was really excited to show you that. Now, you know how we sponged? You know, we sponged the one background that we put behind here. Here is a sponged background as well. And so I just thought this was kind of cool. I just thought I would show it to you. Kind of fun, just another idea, right? So this is cut in the cardstock. This is cut in a small piece of cardstock that I sponged. You could add it right on top if you wanted to. Just got to get it lined up. Where's his face? Where are you? Oh my. It's hard to do this when you're like, you know, trying to be quick here. Okay, there we go. Okay, well, y'all get the idea, right? So here, let me show you this one. This one's a little bit darker anyway, so I think this one would be better. There we go. Oh, look at that. I pulled it together. Nice. So there you have it like that. And then you could, like I said earlier, you could pop him underneath with, you know, pink, or you could pop him underneath with an orange or a yellow or any kind of color that you wanted. So I just thought that was a really cool way to kind of play with him. So here, check out this one. Oh, you know what? Before I show you that one, I have to show you how I colored him. So here we go. Let me show you this really quick too. So this is the goldfish. And I think he's absolutely beautiful. You know, when I think of the goldfish, I actually really think of like betta fish. I love betta fish. And so I started to kind of play with this one. And let me show you, it's really easy to cut him out as well if you wanted to do that. I just snipped him right here. And then I'm also going to snip him right here really quickly and easily. And then he's also attached right up by his face. Just a small little cut, and then also a little cut right here. So now he is free. So really easy. This is the die. Super easy to put through your cut and emboss machine. So pretty fantastic. All right, so this guy, I've got to pull out my sample. I had a lot of fun coloring this one too. So I am really looking forward to showing you this one. So this one is Coastal Cabana. And maybe a bit of Bermuda Bay, you know, because that's what we do. And so I'm just gonna kind of make sure that's clean. So we're gonna start with some Coastal Cabana. And I just sort of came in on this guy. And, you know, I'm just kind of adding a bit of blue in here. Not getting too crazy quite yet. There's plenty of time for getting crazy. So we're just kind of adding some color in here and kind of, you know, just adding some color. Now I am adding some of the colors to his fins, but I don't want to cover it, if you will. I do kind of want it, you know, just sort of a nice layer of color, but not covered. So now I'm going to pull out my Bermuda Bay, and there's my Bermuda Bay, and I'm going to try just to tap the top of my brush and kind of come right here in the center. I'm kind of just wanting the center of his body to be just a little bit darker, maybe a bit more, you know, accented. I'm going to also add a bit of darker Bermuda kind of in his fin in here a little bit. Not much, just a wee bit. Okay, super. So I think we're coming along quite nicely. And I want to accent his face a little bit, just a bit. Okay, and so now what I'm going to do is I thought, what about some razzleberry? What do you guys think about some razzleberry?
I like it.
You like it? All right. Why are y'all laughing at me over there? Y'all laughing at me? I know, I like razzleberry. So here we go. I've got razzleberry. I am coming in, and I am going. The cool thing that I found is that if you blend it, it actually starts to get purple, like into the blue. Like it starts to kind of become like a its own color, if you will. So it's really cool. And so you can also take your, you know, you can take your blue if you wanted to, your Bermuda Bay, and you could certainly add more to him. But I'm just kind of adding a bit. Oh, isn't that beautiful so far? I know it's hard to see because he's on top of my already blended area, but I'm just going to kind of add a bit darker to the tips of his fins. Just a bit darker here on each side. Just like that. Okay, so check him out. Oh, isn't he just beautiful? He is absolutely stunning. And so that, if you wanted to recreate that at home, that's Bermuda Bay, Rich Razzleberry, and then Coastal Cabana. Those are your three colors to achieve that look. So then what I did is I actually did the exact same thing that I did with the other card, and I added my little fish up there. And this is actually the soft succulents. No, let me take that back. This one in here is the fresh freesia. So it's the purpley one. And then these down here are the succulents. And then what I did is, do you guys remember when I did the soft succulent stamp set and we used the fine tip glue pen and we added some color to him? Well, we didn't add color, if you will, but we kind of made him look wet. Well, I did the exact same thing here. So let's see, can you see that? I don't know if you can get the shimmer in there. But I just added it to his gills and then I added some to his fins. So, you know, definitely takes a bit of patience, but you know, you don't have to be perfect. You could probably just do a bunch of squiggly lines, just kind of all over. But what I found is it really enhances the color, especially these dark colors down here. And so if you add that glue to it, it looks wet. And when it dries, it's just beautiful. Just beautiful. And if you look here, no fish is probably going to turn out the same. As you can see, this one kind of has more of some purpley's and things in it. So, you know, that's what I love, is that they all turn out different. So I hope you guys like this one too. Let me show you its, you know, its friend and its, you know, and it's a greeting card family. So there they are. Just simple, super easy. This is stamped in Rich Razzleberry. So that's what that one is stamped in. So I just love that. So I thought that was super cool. So if you guys like my cards so far, I would really appreciate if you would give me a thumbs up and just do it once. That'll help me grow my channel. And of course, if you haven't already subscribed, please do so. You're going to want to click the notification bell so that you will get notified next time I share a video. And I will also next week have PDF tutorials. Peyton is here and she is amazing, just as Amanda and Priscilla are too. And they are helping me get some tutorials done for you guys. So very, very excited about that. Okay. So here we go. I want to show you one more thing before I go. And this is Balmy Blue. And I really liked this image. And let's see, I should have some Balmy Blue ink here. Let me go down into the depths of my drawer here. And the Deep Blue Sea, that's exactly right. So what I found is I actually liked this stamped off and then I stamped it on. Actually, I'm gonna take that back. I like it stamped on. Perfect. And then, but you know what? I could totally stamp the back and some, oh, look at that. That's, whoo, that's not good. Anyway, we're moving on. So that is a mistake, but you know what? I'm not too terribly worried about it because we're gonna layer it with some other cardstock. So that's why, you know, no need to panic. We just make the layers bigger. You know, that's all good. So what I'm gonna do is I have shaded spruce here and I also have some granny apple green. And then I have some white, some basic white. So as you can see, layering that up, that's quite beautiful, isn't it? And so then what I did is I took some coral and I added a bit of color to my coral again. And I'm gonna go ahead and just show you that. So here's my coral. I have granny apple green and I also have shaded spruce. So what I found is when you're doing this one, I started with the darker color. You could certainly start with the lighter, but I think for me, it makes more sense for me to come in from the bottom and start with my darker color and then work my way up so it kind of blends, you know, blends into it. So I have, you know, I'm just kind of adding some dark pieces in here. Okay, just wiping off my brush, getting it nice and clean. And then I'm gonna grab some granny apple green. And oh, now it comes to life. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And so you could leave some white if you wanted to, of course. And I do like the different shades of green on that. So then you add that to your card. And holy moly, it's absolutely cool. So beautiful. And then you've got some coral. Then you have these cute little fish. These little fish pop out as well. Or our die cut. There's actually one die, you get two fish. The cool thing is I haven't figured out yet why, oh, I see why one's going the other direction. Mm-hmm. How cool is that? Because they have them different on here. Well, golly, you know, it took me a little while to figure that out. I'm thinking, no gosh, I didn't die cut it that way. Okay, so that guy's swimming that way, which is super cool. That guy's swimming that way. And so what I did is I took my Daffodil Delight, and I colored this guy. And I went ahead and colored this guy in some really pretty yellow. So I made him nice and bright and yellow. Then there's also these little fish. There's some little fish in there. And so I stamped my fish in Bermuda Bay, and then I stamped my fish off. I really liked the stamped off fish. And after I did that, then I just cut them out. There's no die cut for that. So I just kind of cut around them. And I sort of positioned them inside my card as though they were swimming. And then I did another one. And then I just cut my third one out. All right. So I know we're getting running out of time. So I'm going to go ahead and put these away. And then I'm going to show you my final card for the day. Oh, I'm excited. So yeah, it's this card right here that we're working on. Here, let's just move that so you can't see the mistake right there. There we go. Perfect. Okay. So here is the finished one. How cool is that? I gotta save this so I can put that together later. So here is the finished one. Absolutely gorgeous. So fun. So this is shaded spruce on here. Shaded spruce, granny apple green. And this is your balmy blue on the balmy blue cardstock, Bermuda Bay. And then of course you have some bumblebee or daffodil delight kind of mixed in there. I also used my fine tip glue pen to kind of add some shimmer or to kind of give it that wet look. So it's super cool. And then I finished it off with my evening evergreen gem. So really fun, really cool, super, 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 super easy way to pull that one together. So I could go on and on because I've had so much fun with this. But I'm going to ask that Peyton kind of zoom out a little bit so that I can show you more of the cards from today. And let's see, let's go ahead and put our tall ones here in the back. And so we have those. And then what else did we do here? So let's see. So we have our just different colors, right? Then we have the fun fish. And then we have that one. Oh, so I'm excited to hear which one y'all like the best. It's a hard pick, man. It's a hard one. I kind of go between this one and then this one, but then I like him, but then I go back to him. I can't pick. I love them all. I think they're so much fun, and you know what? This is just scratching the surface. I think there are so many more wonderful things that you guys can do with these dies and the stamp set. So, and then of course, if you add those layering diorama dies in there, you get, you know, kind of get that really cool effect with water. And so that is on my radar. So I'm super excited about that. So I hope that everybody enjoyed these cards. And like I said, if you haven't already done so, be sure to give me a thumbs up if you liked it. So that way, you know, it'll help me grow my channel, and I would really, really appreciate that. And don't forget to subscribe too. I can hear Dylan in the background saying, tell him to subscribe, right? Hi, Joan and Janice. Hello there. Oh my gosh. Hi, Gloria. Did you hear that you won the In Blooms bundle? Yeah, you did. So I'm excited about that. All right, so I'm going to pull these up, but don't go anywhere yet because I have a couple more things to show you. So today, I was in the craft room here working hard, so I did not have the opportunity to email this out yet, but I will for sure tomorrow. So in case you didn't hear yet, Stampin' Up! Is doing a United Through Creativity digital download. This is my printer kind of screwing up, so don't look at that. But anyway, this is a digital download that's completely free. If you're not sure what a digital download is, basically you would download it to your computer and you would print it off. And then you can print it off on nice cardstock, and then you can use it in your craft room. Now, they created these images for World Diversity Day. They wanted a day for communities to all come together and understand the value of cultural diversity. And so they felt that these images kind of bring all of that together. So that'll help us share projects with friends around the world. And so we would love for you to create with this digital download and do a hashtag United Through Creativity and hashtag Diversity Day. And you can share these, you know, on all of your social media sites. So they're just really fun. You know, we belong together, and then you've got them in the different languages as well. And, you know, we unite our, it says, when we unite our creative, creative light, we lighten people's hearts. And so if you go through here, like I said, they are in different languages, different fonts. You have some different images from different countries that, you know, how's it all going, eh? I like that. And hang in there, here for you through thick and thin. So, and then we have a look, we have just, you know, hoy, and just really cool. So just lots of fun images. So if you would like this download, if you go to brandyscards.com, you're gonna see it in my blog. So you're gonna click on my blog on the, in the top navigational bar, and then you're gonna click on that post, and there's a spot to download this, and you can print these off at home. And you can work with these, all right? So here, let me show you some cards in the mail. I received the most beautiful cards in the mail, and I'm always so excited to share them with you. So I thought this was a super fun and clever idea. You know, taking a bought card, right? Because I could see that. This was from Miss Diane, and she took that card and she stamped on it. How fun is that? I have never thought about taking a card and making it even more tailored using a stamp. So I thought that was super fun. And so this card is from Sharon, and I love that too, so pretty. And check this one out, this one is so nice too. So this one has some seeds in it. So we've got some poppies, and as you can see, there's some poppies here in the seeds. So what a cute idea, right? So this one is from Debbie Michael. Debbie's actually on my team. Absolutely beautiful. I love that. And I will definitely be using those seeds. Wow, look at that one. Ooh, that's pretty. So that one's from Donna. Oh, so pretty. So pretty. Love it. All right. And then we have Trudy's card. And then we have Sheila. So look how pretty that is. So pretty. Here's another one. So let's see who this one. This was Miss Donna. And as you can see, when you open it, it kind of, actually, wait a second here. What did I do? Oh, I see. This one kind of pops up. There we go. It was a little stuck. Look how pretty that is. So it's kind of a, you know, kind of sits up and it's just really pretty. Look at those butterflies. Stunning. So pretty, Donna. This one is from Betty. Oh, Betty, this is so pretty. So pretty. I feel like maybe you did this one for our color challenge, for our team color challenge. Absolutely stunning. I love, love, love the green. It's kind of what I did today on that seahorse. So you should try that on your seahorse. And then Miss Donna. This is so cool. I love this. And look at her wings. I think she put some Wink-a-Stella on there. And up in here. I loved this stamp set. Oh, I'm sad that one's gone. But, you know, out with some of the old and in with lots of the new. So it's always nice too. Okay. So I think that is it for cards in the mail. And, you know, I think that is, that is it for cards in the mail and for my crafting today. So I'm going to look down and I hope that you all really, really liked those cards. Just so much fun to make. And I just really was excited to share these with you. And so, you know, there's just not enough time. And I could do this for like another 30 minutes. An hour
or more. Yeah.
Or more. They're laughing at me because I've only been trying to create for you for the last couple of days. So as you know, you can go into your craft room and you can spend all kinds of time. And that is the beauty, honestly, of Stampin' Up and paper crafting, is that it's therapeutic and it just really takes your mind off the day. And then you come up with these beautiful creations that you can send to others, just like Roxy and many of you out there who, you know, send them to the nursing homes and the Ronald McDonald houses out there, to your friends and family, and to strangers that you don't know that you want to lift up. So lots of reasons to make our cards and to send them, for sure. All right, so I see that Amanda has posted cards in the mail, so thank you for that, Amanda. So the cards in the mail address, she has posted that inside of the comments. So we, you know, you can definitely send those and we'll share those here. And Charlotte, hi Charlotte, thanks for being in here. And Miss Angela and Patty and Mommy Rue, hello there. And Susan Drew, thank you, Susan, for being in here. I'm so glad that you liked my cards tonight. So, of course, you know, it wouldn't be a Brandy's Cards video if I didn't give something away. It brings me quite, you know, lots of joy to share these blessings with all of you. So if you leave a comment in the comment section, once this video has been shut off, when it's ended, you have to leave it in the comments. In the chat where we're at right now, this does not register in the comments. So in order for the computer to kind of put you in that mix, you have to leave a note in the comments. So make sure you do that. I have another Seascape bundle that I'm excited to send to somebody. So we will announce that on our next Friday fun night, live night. So, okay, well, I think that about does it for me. Again, if you don't already have a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, please let me know. I'd love the opportunity to help you and earn your business. And if you're thinking about joining Stampin' Up! And you would like to take it for a little test drive as a hobby demonstrator to get the discount, or maybe as a career demonstrator, I'd love the opportunity to help you. We've got a great team, very supportive and loving, and we have a lot of fun. We're all addicted. We all raise our right hand. And, you know, we are addicted to stamping, but it's just a lot of fun. So, all right. Thank you for being with me tonight. I hope that you guys have a wonderful and safe weekend. Take care. Until next time. Bye, everybody.